The Tuscan city of Florence enjoys a level of fame that is almost unrivaled, and that's due to its wealth of cultural assets, its eye for beauty, and its flair for design. But underlying these assets, and linked to them, are sometimes underappreciated competencies in high technology.
Florence is very well known around the world, but most people know only half of its story. The city's industrial and economic might is usually overshadowed by its sheer prettiness, just as its modern edge is overshadowed by the city's fascinating past. That is something local officials would like to correct. Four priority sectors are being promoted by the city for future inward investment: culture, education, fashion and design, and high technology. Florence ranks first in Italy for total number of companies working in what could be described as the cultural production system, and the city's becoming an international leader in advanced technology and high value-added services for cultural heritage. Meanwhile, Florence throughout the ages has been a center for learning, with scholars flocking to the city from around the world to live, study, and teach.
Che qui c'è una popolazione di giovani che viene a studiare e a perfezionarsi. Abbiamo più di 40 università americane, abbiamo università francesi, abbiamo l'Istituto Universitario Europeo e un'università con più di 60.000 studenti. Dunque, tanti giovani che possono rappresentare una opportunità di investimento con talenti e professionalità nuove.
American universities have always been keen on Italy. It's the second most popular destination for their study abroad programs after the UK. And within Italy, Florence is an obvious choice. One of the newest arrivals to Florence's academic culture comes from the East, however. China's Tongji University inaugurated a campus in Florence in March 2014 that will serve as an academic support unit of the Shanghai-Florence Sino-Italian Design Exchange Center, which opened at the same time. And while Florence's design skills cut across architecture, industrial and product design, and other segments, it is in fashion where Florentine design has found its greatest fans. Five of the biggest names in Italian fashion have their roots in Florence: Salvatore Ferragamo, Emilio Pucci, Roberto Cavalli, Ermanno Cervino, and Gucci. But there are more players involved. With more than 9,000 companies active in the sector, the province of Florence ranks first in Italy for this figure.
Florence is an extraordinary, unique fashion district. We have such a deep culture in manufacturing fashion that makes this city and this region one of the references worldwide. All the main Italian and international labels have offices here, at least for buying raw materials and then producing the very high end of the production and the products here in Florence.
Those outside of scientific circles don't tend to associate Florence with modern technology. International attention focuses on its role in early discoveries and its Renaissance-era scientific achievements. But there is a solid core of high-tech activity in and around Florence. Foreign companies engaged in advanced engineering and R&D activity in Florence include GE Oil and Gas, Japanese diesel engine maker Yanmar, and Thales, a French multinational that makes electrical systems for the aerospace, defense, transportation, and security industries.
This region is very attractive from a skills point of view, and also from it's very dynamic in terms of PMI, small and medium enterprises, that can support and gives us their contribution to develop our solutions. So from Florence, we export technology. From Florence, we address all the market worldwide.
Technology, of course, underpins all of the other sectors which form the basis of the economy of Florence. And the city's core sectors are woven together like a fine Renaissance tapestry.
Any sector can be interesting, but what makes them particularly relevant, what makes particularly interesting for foreign investors, is the fact they're interlinked. Take, for example, culture. Culture is our sort of bread and butter. However, fruition of culture, restoration of culture, needs technology. And obviously culture spills off into fashion, for instance. So what you have here, I think, it's a good mix, good blend of excellences, from education to high tech to design to fashion.
I hope you've enjoyed this tour of Florence. Join us to see where we go next time on Location.